Circles are actually a better investment tool for members of the society, since the returns that members get from this investment are better compared to the market rate and risk-free rate investments in Kenya. This is according to a research that was done by one Lucy Kirima and Kennedy Wambua in 2017. There's also this other guy called Brown, who argues that most of our time as human beings will be spent in earning and spending money, looking for money and spending it. And in that process, we never get the balance. You never get enough money for your consumption needs. And so what happens? In the process, we'll find ourselves taking loans so that we can balance the equation. We can try to get what we desire to have. Or even sometime we'll end up now saving so that we can have sort of enough to take care of our consumption needs. Where am I going with this? This one is taking us to circles. I want to share more about circles in Kenya today and my experience with them. I am a member of a circle, and just to define what a circle is for those who don't understand what it is a self-help, unique member-driven and democratic cooperative. It is governed, owned, and managed by its members who share a common bond like a labor union, working for the same employer, belonging to the same church, social fraternity, or living in the same community. And you will agree with me that those who are from Kenya, you have seen circles that are run by members of a particular institution. For example, I am a member of a circle that is run by accountants, and it's called Azina Circle. They have not paid me to say this. I'm just saying, I'm just sharing. And you will find other circles like Mwalimu Circle, which is the membership is drawn from the teachers, Ukulima Circle, and many other circles in Kenya that are there. And so what happens with circles? Circles rely on the savings of their members so that they can run, so that they can generate capital to lend the money to other members. So when you're putting money in your circle, then that money is able to be distributed to other members who want to borrow. Even you yourself, when you borrow, you are borrowing from your own and from other people's savings. So there are several benefits of circles, and I have been a beneficiary of my circle. And why I have benefited from my circle is because I've used my circle as an investment mechanism. I don't only use my circle to put money there, get a loan, you know, buy a house or build a house or do something, but I also want to put my money there so that my money can bring more money. The same way a person who has a shop where they are selling, for example, household goods, they have to keep on buying and selling. It is the same way I'm doing with my circle. I am putting in my money there as an investment that gives me a profit at the end of the year, because circles in Kenya give dividends at the end of the year. And so that's the first benefit of a circle, that it's a saving platform. And it also helps its members to grow a culture of saving. If you are a member of a circle, like I was sharing the other day about my sister who started saving this amount of money, and in the process, you know, she dropped off. And when she wanted a loan from this circle, she could not get the loan because she has not been a consistent member in terms of contributions. And that really awoke her, and she started saving again, because she realized that if I want help from this my circle, I have to continue contributing or saving in my account. And so circles are encouraging people to save. They are growing a culture of saving in people, you know, that if I want this and this, I have to do this. And you find yourself saving more. Like myself, I want more dividends. I want more dividends from my circle. So what am I doing? I'm putting in more and more, because that's the kind of investment that I am in currently, people say that the kind of investment that I am doing, it's done by people who are not risk takers. You don't want to risk with your money. You don't want to put your money in this kind of business that, it, you know, it may not come back. The money may disappear or the business may not do well. And so people investing in circles like myself are people who don't like taking risks, which is okay. So long as it is working for me and it is working for you, you can go ahead and do it. And the second benefit of circles is that they give dividends. Circle give dividends at the end of the year. That's what happens in Kenya. We are given dividends at the end of the year. And 1 week ago, I went to collect my dividends. And I was this happy woman. I was excited. And besides the dividend, my circle came up with this idea that I can plow back my dividends. Rather than taking my dividends and consuming the money, that I can put it back and I will get an extra money. And that's what I did. I have always received my dividends and put them back to my account so that they can continue growing. But this time round, my circle told me that I could put my dividends back, and if I put my money back, I am going to get a percentage. And that percentage was, if I put the 100, the whole amount that I got for dividends back, I get a 10% of that. And it was good money. If I put 75% of it, I get 7.5%. of the amount that I have put in. And I decided to plow back all the money that I had received, all my dividends. I put them back and I got the 10% of what had been given as dividend, and it was not little money, as I am saying, and I put it back again. I am not coming back with any cash. This money I'm putting here, I'm putting it to work for me, and I want fruit. I want I want good income from it. So I want it to continue growing and growing. I'm sure one time I have mentioned this again and again, that I will be a millionaire, and not even a millionaire, a billionaire, because I will keep on building it and building it again and again. There are also investment opportunities with circles. You've seen circles coming up with these ideas of buying land in a place far away, for example, say Kitengela or even beyond Kitengela. And then they encourage their members to invest, to buy those pieces of land together. And through the circle, you'll buy that piece of land cheaply than if you took yourself there to buy the land yourself. Because the circle has a lot... a huge chunk of money, and they can buy this huge chunk of land, then they divide it and then sell it to their members, and the rate will be a bit lower compared to the market rate. Instead of receiving those dividends and running with them and going to eat nyama choma, going to buy this dress that I've always wanted, I plow it back. Because then what is the aim of me putting money in this circle? Okay, I can put it for the sake of getting a loan, but I am not big in loans. So for me, getting dividends and plowing them back to my account is the main reason why I am in a circle. Again, there are so many other benefits like emergency loans. If you are in a circle and you want an emergency loan, it's very easy to get that loan. There is also cheap interest rates. When you want to get a loan, the rate is not the same from circles to banks. A bank, you'll get such a big interest rate, while with the circles, you'll get a cheaper one. So circles in Kenya are controlled by an agency called SASRA, which is charged with the role of regulating, licensing, and supervising deposit-taking circle societies in Kenya. So if you decide to get into investing in circles, you can be sure that you're not getting to just an institution that is not well-structured. Circles are controlled by SASRA, so you may want to check if the circle that you want to invest in is under SASRA, because there are some circles that may come up and they have not registered with SASRA, and therefore if you lose money with such an institution, you have nowhere to report or get your money back. But with the circles that are controlled by SASRA, you can be sure you are safe with your money. So for more information about SACCOs in Kenya, you can go to the individual website of various SACCO organizations, or you can also go to SASRA website and you'll get more information about SACCOs in Kenya. You'll also get to understand how the dividend that you get from your SACCO is taxed, what amount it is taxed, and much more. To this end, I hope you have enjoyed the video. I wanted to share this and show you different ways of savings because we've been talking about savings this past month. So I wanted to show you other opportunities of how you can invest, how you can save your money, not necessarily putting it in an account directly, but putting it somewhere where it can give you dividend at the end of the year. And you can consider that an investment. And so until next time, it's a goodbye from me. Hope you like this video. Hope if you have not subscribed, you can subscribe so that we can get to hear more about savings and other areas that I do talk about in this platform.